A monster is climbing on a tree. It opens the window on the side, then stuck its very long tongue inside. Tongue burrowed into the blanket. NHINHA is sleeping soundly at the moment. She woke up because she felt a lot of pain. There was blood on her stomach. She was very scared. In a panic, she turned on the light, saw a tongue stuck in her stomach. Moreover, it was trying to suck the baby in her belly. NHINHA used all her strength to resist. The tongue immediately pulled out and left. At this moment, NHINHA is crawling on the ground. She tries to crawl towards the door. The monster also climbed into the house from outside. It climbed to the ceiling and looked at NHINHA, then stuck out his tongue, plugged into NHINHA's navel. A pitiful cry came from outside, heard by a neighbor who was taking out the trash. Neighbors rushed to the door. At this moment, NHINHA is going to take the phone to ask for help, but be careful not to knock a table down. She picked up the broken piece of the lamp, then used it to cut the monster's tongue. The monster painfully retracted its tongue and ran away. Neighbors also rushed over, saw NHINHA lying on the ground. She quickly informed the police. This side, Dio Long is taking a break. After receiving the report, he was a little worried, because that address is his friend's house. Dio Long quickly went to the scene. Upstairs came a cry for help. The two immediately ran up, saw NHINHA lying on the ground. Dio Long is very worried. He put his hand on the pulse in her neck. Luckily, she's still alive. Colleagues called 120 and then gave NHINHA's first aid. Her husband returned to see his wife in such a state. He is very excited. The two Dio Long quickly held him back for fear that he would disturb NHINHA. After a while, NHINHA was lying on the ambulance. Seeing NHINHA's appearance at this time, Dio Long was very worried. All things happening were all seen by the monster in the tree. Soon Chris and Han were on the scene. Dio Long went over to tell the two of them about the situation. There were blood stains everywhere in the room. The blood still stretches out the window. There are scratches on the window. Furthermore, the tree outside the window had a lot of scratches like that. They interrogated the neighbor who reported the crime, but neighbors did not see the killer with their own eyes. When she arrived, she only saw NHINHA lying on the ground, but she confirmed that a third person appeared at the scene because she heard a terrible scream. The two then went to the hospital. The doctor told them, NHINHA is temporarily no longer dangerous, but the fetus in her belly had already run out of amniotic fluid. This can lead to premature birth or stillbirth. They found NHINHA's husband, Kyo Dan. At that time, he went out to buy medicine, not at home. When he returned, the police were already at the scene. This Tio Long already knew. The two Chris felt there was nothing left to investigate, immediately returned to the police station. Dio Long is not sure about NHINHA, so he always stayed to protect her. Seeing his expression, immediately knew. It seems that he and NHINHA used to have some kind of special relationship. Kyo Dan went into the hospital room, then told Dio Long to go home and rest first. It's okay to have him here. Dio Long looked at NHINHA again and left. After Dio Long left, Kyo Dan immediately called his brother. In the conversation, Kyo Dan seems to know who NHINHA's case was made by someone. That woman is here. This deal happened sooner or later, but I don't want that to happen. So how are you going to handle it? Please help me find where that woman is now. This side, Dio Long dreamed of her childhood. Grandma is telling him a story about a monster that eats fetuses. Dio Long suddenly woke up, saw that monster break into his room from the window. Dio Long was afraid to wake up. Turns out it was just a dream. He threatened to terror and so, he quickly turned on the light and looked towards the window. Luckily, it's okay. The next day, Chris received a notification from the hospital. NHINHA has woken up. The two rushed to the hospital. The doctor told them, in NHINHA's body there is a toxin. This toxin can cause a person to go into a coma. Two people entered the hospital room, then asked NHINHA what happened last night. But NHINHA doesn't remember anything about last night. She only remembers when she woke up in pain. Then what happened, she no longer remembers. Dio Long is very worried about NHINHA. He found his brother, then ask about your childhood. Grandma told them a story about a monster that eats fetuses. Then the two talked about NHINHA. It turned out that Dio Long and NHINHA were young. There was a time when they were in love with each other, even though they can't be together. But Dio Long still can't forget NHINHA. This side, Kyo Dan received a phone call from his brother. He found a woman's address. Kyo Dan relies on the address to go to a house. The person who opened the door was an old woman. Kyo Dan got angry and rushed into the room. It turned out that she was the mother of Kyo Dan. They are all fetus-eating monsters. Their monster race has a tradition. The eldest son must give his mother his first child to prolong the life of his mother. If he doesn't follow, within half a month the mother will be dead, and Kyo Dan is her eldest son. but he didn't want to sacrifice his son for that. He gave his mother a train ticket, then leave. She was very angry, revealed his true body and tore the ticket. In the hospital, Tia Long is helping NHI and HA pack her things. NHI and HA is very grateful for Tia Long's help, even gave him a hug. Chris felt that there was something unusual about this case. The killer is most likely a monster. He called Triffin and Evan over. Go to the warehouse to find materials. It wasn't long before they found out information based on what was written in ancient books. But this monster survives by eating fetuses. So the culprit who took action with NHI and HA is most likely this monster. On the side, after work, Tia Long never returned home. He still did not ignore the story of NHI and HA. At this moment, suddenly a taxi came. A woman got out of the car. She did not enter through the main door, but directly climbed the tree. This made Tia Long very suspicious. Kao Dan was in the room and heard a noise outside. NHI and HA heard a loud noise and woke up. Now she went to her room. Then said that she was the mother of Kao Dan. When she heard that NHI and HA was pregnant, she quickly went here even in midnight. NHI and HA did not have any doubts. She listened to what she said and lay down on the bed. After that, she did not stop singing folk songs, causing NHI and HA to slowly fall into a coma. She suddenly reappeared, then started sucking the fetus. At this time, Tia Long felt that something was wrong, immediately jumped in, saw Kao Dan is lying on the ground. Tia Long realizes that something is not right. He quickly ran upstairs. Chris and two others also arrived in time. In the room, Tia Long and the other demon are in conflict with each other, but Tia Long is not the opponent of that monster. In an instant, he fell to the ground. Right when the monster was about to kill Tia Long, then there was a gunshot from behind. The monster was shot dead. Tia Long was so scared that he peed his pants. He saw the monster slowly transform back into a human form. Chris and the others were not afraid of such monsters. But for Tia Long, this is the first time. He really can't stand it. This made him mentally unstable. In another scene, this witch girl is about to give birth. Next to her now is only a younger brother. Her brother always encouraged her spirit. Finally, a baby was born. The next generation of two witches, definitely not normal. In the next episode, the archaeologist will discover the set of mummies, but was already inside by the monster. Thank you for watching. I'm Zan. See you in the next episode.